Just a couple hours south of Tucson, you can birdwatch, rent a boat, even take a twilight cruise.
Don't let the dirt trails and cactus fool you. There really is water over them there hills.
When people come here the first time, they just are blown away by how beautiful it is being so close to Tucson in the desert area. A lot of people call it the hidden gem of southern Arizona. The lake is actually 265 surface acres, which is about 2.5 miles long.
Surrounded by the Santa Rita and Patagonia Mountains, Patagonia Lake is man-made, created by the dam built over Sonoyta Creek.
We're one of the largest bodies of water. We actually are the largest body of water in the southeast within the next 100 miles that actually allows water skiing, wakeboarding, and tubing. Half of the lake is a no-wake zone, which makes it really nice for fishing, kayaking, and canoeing.
And it's prime fishing conditions even for the wildlife. But looks like this is more of a catch and release. Whether you prefer people power, horsepower, or wind power.
That bridge is so awkward to walk because it was intended to allow sailboats through.
Patagonia Lake State Park has plenty of options and amenities.
We have 120 campsites. 105 of those actually have electric and water. So most of our campsites are available for trailers and RVs, or if you just want to charge your cell phones, just to make it more comfortable.
And having electricity means I can plug in my hairdryer.
Our shower houses, we have one on both sides of the lake, the east and the west side. And each of those has hot running showers, not just the push button kind, but the kind you can turn on and take a nice long warm shower, which is very nice when you've been camping all day.
The comforts of home right on the waterfront. But even though you're miles away from the city, you can still run into a traffic jam. But it's the kind of gridlock you won't mind sitting around waiting to clear.
2 weekends ago when we came out, there were 8 great blue herons in this last cottonwood tree over here. Yep, there's a great blue heron on the left-hand side of that tree sitting on a nest that's built.
See it.
First one that I've heard of in the park.
Arizona Highways Television is brought to you by Arizona Public Service and the Arizona Office of Tourism.